Okay, well, I don't know if this is actually going to work. I just got a brand new camera, and we're going to go out for a little ride. Heading down to Puyallup for a little Sonic drive-in motorcycle get-together. It's only 15 minutes away, however, it is rush hour. So we're going to see what happens and how long it actually takes me. My phone is telling me about 45 minutes. I have a feeling it's going to be a little over an hour. Hopefully some of my little back roads will help slightly. And again, I'm sorry if this angle's off. I don't know quite where it's pointing. I just tried to get the estimate. I'm going to end up probably moving the mount just because I couldn't find the right spot. I think I need to get some more attachments and things. For now, it'll work as a test run. So it's supposed to be 70 degrees out today, and you feel it when you're in the sun, but now that I don't have my liner in my jacket, it's a little chilly, so we're going to see how cold it gets tonight. And yes, you did see that, a Boosta owner waving at somebody else. see if I can actually hear anything by the time I get there, because this bike is pretty freaking loud. I did bring earplugs just in case, but I'll actually have to pull over to put them in, of course. You know, I haven't really watched too many motovlogging episodes. I figure I'd just talk about random crap, and I don't know, people actually watch the whole freaking video. Maybe it makes it more interesting, but I'm just doing, well, I guess I'm doing almost 40 miles an hour. Nothing crazy, we're just riding around. So I'm gonna try that. I'm gonna talk about random crap and see who actually watches this damn thing. There was a house on that property, and they knocked it down and put some rocks and then left it. I don't know what they were doing. It wasn't a bad-looking house. I don't know if the city of Auburn owns it or what. Yes, I will say hi to cops, too. One day, they're going to pull me over, and maybe they'll remember me actually saying hi. Not that they wave back, but hey, it is what it is. GPS on my phone really wants me to take 167, but I know that's not the best way. It's a straight shot, but it's a straight shot into a parking lot. The one thing that I can't get over, well, besides the smell of fuel, is this vibration I get when I'm in neutral and the clutch out. I pulled in the clutch, it stops. I don't know if it's the vacuum pulsing on that boost lockup clutch or what. I know it's definitely coming from the clutch, I just don't know why. Other than that, when I start rolling, let the clutch out, everything seems fine. And yeah, she's going. I don't know if anybody who watches my videos knows about bikini baristas, but that little hut back there, they're everywhere in Washington. You know, you pay $5 for a coffee at Starbucks, well, you can pay $5 for a coffee there and get a bikini barista. Might have some pasties on. I don't know. If it's your cup of tea, go for it. I guess the girl's got to go through medical college or something somehow. Me, personally, I'm just not that big of a coffee person. I like the smell of coffee, and I like the thought of coffee, but I like more cream with just a little bit of coffee. Nice move, okay. Sorry, I just like looking at myself sometime in the reflections. Was interesting. Guy riding a motorcycle wearing, I don't know what you call them, farmer pants, is what I'm gonna call them. And people give squids or sport bike riders so much shit for not wearing a jacket or not wearing full leathers when they're riding, and you got that on the Harley, so I guess we just expect it. I don't know. People up here in Washington, somebody posts a picture of just somebody wearing a t-shirt, helmet, gloves, because there is a helmet law. Give them so much shit, and I'm kind of like, you know what? They need to come down to Albuquerque, New Mexico. No helmet law. You have to wear some kind of eye protection, but it's just normal out there. And honestly, I really don't care. There are times when I'm parked and, okay, I'm going to drive a half a block up. I don't want to get suited up, put on my freaking helmet to go up the block. And I know it's controversial. If it's my fault. If something happens and I get injured, it's my damn fault. Unless it was somebody else's fault. But it was my choice. So far so good, making some decent time. I'm gonna keep my fingers crossed. It's definitely different riding the bike without the plastics. I'm kind of one of those guys that, you know, I don't want to make it look like I crashed the damn bike. I try to keep her nice and clean, but with as much work, as many little problems as I've had, it's such a pain in the ass to keep taking the damn plastics off. So for now, I'm going to swallow my pride, just trying to put some miles on her, keep the plastic off, make it easy. I'm changing the oil filter after almost every ride, and it's different. Everybody else also gets to see what I've done or what's been hiding under that stuff. Probably should have moved over because there's a city bus. Gonna get stuck behind him. Another bikini barista stand. Actually, I probably passed about two of them already. Put on some music for me. You won't be able to hear it, but if you hear me radio on, if you hear me talking or singing, it's not because I'm, well, it's part of radio on. I am very surprised. Definitely a lot less traffic than I was thinking. Or at least expecting. I don't want to turn left. I want to go straight. Sorry if I just whacked the crap out of the camera. Another reason why I need to switch the position.
assuming that was some kind of quarry. Quarry. Hey. Roads. Wish I could see, but 167 is over that way, and it was just dark red, traffic sitting still almost. Definitely moving faster than that. I guess this is a good time to say, hey, if anybody has anything they'd like to see other than, you know, power poles and getting on the boost, which I love too, but right now I'm trying to take it easy. Stuff I should talk about. Let me know. I'll see if I can oblige. Yes, I know, I need to turn left. It told me like 5 freaking times. It's like, what the hell's a school zone on for? I mean, ...6 o'clock at night. Hopefully no cameras, but I should be into that. Well, that lady looks mean. She's got that death stare on that kid. She's like, get your ass over here. This is awesome, because normally this is kind of like a parking lot. Oh, and just in case anybody's asking, you know, I said I'm leaving during rush hour. Seattle's rush hour is anywhere between 3 and 7 p.m. It says I'm about to come up on a traffic jam. I gotta figure out where in the hell I'm going. I memorized it somewhat up to this point, but, okay, just stay there for a minute. Screw it. I'm just going to keep going where I'm going. Let's see if we can stop so I can pull the glove out of my crotch. Already my clutch hand is cramping up a little bit. I guess that's what I get for having a higher pressure springs and all that sort of thing. This is a good time to practice my my slow cruising or idling or okay, maybe not for too long. Temperature's still good. Oil should be good. I got fuel for at least another 20 miles. And now I have a back itch, which I can't get to because of my stupid back protector. turn on my LEDs for when I get there. Says I got 5.5 miles. I can honestly say that I have not been this far down this road before. If I did, I do not remember it at all. About 1200 RPM, third gear, 20 miles an hour. I still got to get a little bit used to the gears because I went from a 20-tooth front to a and a 42 rear to a 19 tooth front, because the 20 tooth was actually rubbing on my sprocket cover. And then I went to a 41 on the rear, so I can definitely tell the gearing is a little bit higher or taller, I guess. It's a little bit tougher to get her off the line. Again, I just need some getting used to. I can feel my right foot getting a little warm. I don't know if that's from the sun or the exhaust on it. Almost there. Oh gosh, freaking clutch hand. You would think they'd be a little stronger or able to take a little more just because I'm carrying crap all day, but then that's probably why they can't handle so much, because I'm carrying crap all day. I guess we're gonna try this right turn. Thank you. less than 5 minutes away. We are at the bike night. Of course, my camera on the Boosta went out early, but here's some action. Just a lot of bikes hanging out. Try to take a little walk around. Not a bad little turnout tonight. I think I got a lot of people. People smoking pot. Of their Groms and Z125s. They look like fun. One of these days I might try one. They definitely get some attention.